What it do? How'd you do? I thought I'd write down some rules for me and you. Don't break the rules, just listen through, and I will show you how to make a proper brew. Like, first you wanna boil the kettle, and don't sit down in this time or allow yourself to settle. Ensure there's sufficient water before you turn it on, and check that it's plugged in at the wall if it's working wrong. Next you wanna shout to everyone who's in the house, make sure it's loud and clear, they have to be allowed to hear. Repeat these words and then remember that it's got to be a genuine attempt, and then scream, do you wanna tea? Listen carefully, responses will vary based on distance and the thickness of the walls that they're shouting from. Count the yeses, neglect the noes, then make your way to the cupboard where the cups go. So, take out the appropriate amount of cups that relates to the amount of yeses you received when you shouted up. It's an important rule, whenever you make a brew, remember the more tea you make for others, the more they'll make for you. This etiquette will see you through some deep winters, there's a karmic force underlying the principles of tea drinkers. What comes around goes around, and no one likes a tea drinker that won't make the next round. But away from morality and back to the tea. Take out the tea bags, add them to the corresponding cups. Everyone has a favourite mug. It's only right that if theirs is there and you're making tea for that person, then try to fill that one up. By now the kettle should have boiled, but if it hasn't, wait. A watch kettle never boils, do something to keep your mind away. If you're not aware of the preferences of those you're making tea for, you have a duty to find out, you should have done this before. But it's okay, no need to feel guilty, just shout something up like how many sugars and how milky. Remember this, it's totally blatant, my friend, it's both obvious and abhorrent to get it wrong, so they won't ask you to make it again, get it right. Pour the now finished boiling water into the cups and pour through the tea bag. This releases the flavour. Remember the milk preference before recorded and judge the amount of space required to leave that. Now that every cup is filled, and it is, add your teaspoon to the mix and give it a little swish. This allows the bag's flavour to be released into the mix, and as it brews, you can retire to the fridge. Pull out the milk and take off the top. Sniff it, even if it was opened only this morning, there's no way it could have gone off. Return to the mugs, the steam is burning, so just take caution with this procedure. It can't be performed in a rush. Again, the teaspoon's your friend, a wonderful thing. Use it to mix the tea until it reaches the right colouring. Then add sugar, concentration is vital. Don't forget, just be sure to add sugar only to the correct mugs. I find 20 stirs will fully allow the sugar to be mixed up. And when you're done, ensure you tap your spoon on the side of the mug. Now if someone's sitting down, take their tea to them. Them standing up to get it themselves kinda defeats the purpose. As a tea drinker and taker, always ask the question, is that alright? You have a duty to make it perfect. Next, grab your tea and settle on the couch. Wait till you hear the universal seal of approval from somebody's mouth. Don't jump the gun, be sure not to ask. Don't say it yourself, let people relax. And then finally it's over when somebody says the customary lovely that. Thank you, that was a nice cup of tea. Cheers mate, nice.